And I've learned to love me too. Never have I felt that I could be all that you see. It's like our hearts have intertwined into the perfect harmony. This is why I love you. Ooh, this is why I love you. Because you love me. You love me. This is why I love you. Ooh, this is why I love you. Because you love me.
And watch her where she goes, and help her to be wise. Help me to let go. Guide her with your grace. Give her faith.
fantastic point of view. No one to tell us no, or where to go, or say we're only dreaming.
A whole new world, a dazzling place I never knew. But when I wake up here, it's crystal clear that now I'm in a whole new world with you.
Now I'm in a
unbelievable sights.
Ladies and gentlemen, I would like to take this opportunity on behalf of the bride and the groom and their families to welcome all of you today to this very auspicious ceremony. We're gathered here today before God, our families and friends, to celebrate the marriage of Alicia Ruth Thomas and Percy Vincent McKinney. We are gathered to rejoice in the gift of love, a love that our Creator shares with us. We affirm today that God, who is both Creator and Sustainer of life, desires us to fully experience our humanity. None of us can be an island isolated without need for community with others. We offer praise and thanks to God, who has blessed us with the wonders of life, breath, hearts, and mind. We rejoice in the realization that we are most alive when we wholeheartedly embrace the gift of God, the gift that He has given us, especially the gift of love. And God wants us to embrace love in all its form. At this time, I'll invite the audience to stand as we ask God's guidance on these proceedings. Let us pray. Eternal God, we are so grateful today for the demonstration of love that you have bestowed on us, that even in times of despair and heartaches, you have given us reason to express our love, love for you and love for others. And so today we come to witness this miracle of love between two of your children. And I pray that your Holy Spirit now will take control of this ceremony. And we give you thanks and we give you the glory. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. At this time, we will have a scripture reading. No, special music, rather, sorry. Special music.
That we should be together. It's unbelievable how I used to say I fall never. The basis is need to know so you can know just how I feel. So let me show you now that I'm for real. If all things in time will reveal, when you're like a dream come true, two, just wanna be with you, three, girl, it's plain to see that you're the only one for me, and four, repeat steps one, two, three, and five. Fall in love with me. If ever I believe my work is done, then I'll start back at one. It's so incredible the way things work themselves out, and all emotional once you know what it's all about. It undesirable for for us to be apart. Never would have made it very far. 'Cause you know you've got the keys to my heart. Oh, one, you're like a dream come true. Two, just wanna be with you. And three, girl, it's plain to see that you're the only one for me. And four, repeat steps one through three. And five, make you fall in love with me. Forever I believe my work is done. Then I'll start back at one. Say farewell to the dark night. I see the coming of the sun. I feel like a little child whose life has just begun. You came and breathed new life into this lonely heart of mine. You threw out the lifeline just in the nick of time. One, oh, two, just wanna be with you. And three, girl, it's plain to see that you're the only one for me. And four, repeat steps one through three. And five, oh, if ever I believe my work is done, then I start back at one. If ever I believe my work is done, then I start back at one.
Amazing, amazing. She's good. Dearly beloved, we're gathered here today in the sight of God and in the presence of this congregation to join this man and this woman in holy matrimony, which is an honorable estate instituted by God in the time of man's innocence, signifying unto us the mythical union that is between Christ and his church, which holy estate Christ adorned and beautified with his presence and first miracle in the Canaan of Galilee, and therefore is not by any to be enterprised nor taken in hand unadvisedly, lightly, or wantingly to satisfy man's carnal desires and appetites, but reverently, discreetly, advisedly, soberly, and in the fear of God, duly considering the cause for which matrimony was ordained, which are for the procreation of children, for the avoidance of fornication, that such person as of not the gift of celibacy might marry, and for the mutual of society, for help and comfort that the one ought to have for another, both in prosperity and in adversity. Into which holy estate these two persons here present today to be joined. Therefore, if any man can show any just cause why they may not be joined lawfully together, let him now speak, or else hereafter, forever, hold his peace. And you don't have to worry, nobody has anything to say. Alicia, Percy, I require and charge you both, as ye will answer at the day of judgment, when the secret of all hearts shall be disclosed, that if any of you have any cause or impediments why you may not be lawfully joined together in matrimony, you do now confess it. For be assured that so many are coupled together, otherwise than God's word doth allowed, or the laws of New York requires, are not joined together by God, neither are their matrimony recognized by the United States of America. Alicia, Percy, to create a life together with the blessings of God requires that you honor God, honor each other, and honor yourself. That you also honor the many voices of the soul, the joys, the delights, the love, as well as the anger, the fear, the illness, the unhealed wounds. That you may not ask your life partner to be anything less than a fully formed human person, committed to you in love, but still possessed by that strange and sometimes bewildering gift of freedom. That we ought to accept each other for all that they are, embracing each other in all our complexities, in times of delight, in the fullness of dreams, in moments of sorrow, conflicts, or loss. That is both God's blessing and charge to you, to live together with courage and honor, whatever time in its unfolding mystery may bring. So my question to both of you, are you prepared to accept each other for all that you are? Did you hear that?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. Who gave this woman to be married to this man? Thank you so much. You may be seated. So today, it is my understanding that both Alicia and Percy has some sentimental words for each other. So at this time, they want to pour out their souls to each other before all of you. And we will give them the opportunity to do so.
Alicia, when I first saw you, I was captured by your beauty. I was only 11, it was nothing serious. I was not too young to know I liked you, but I was determined to know you. That was 13 years ago, and even though life separated us, I knew you were the one. Baby girl, it was love at first sight. I respect you as a person with your own interests, desires, and needs. And I promise to always try. And I promise to always try and accept you for who you are. I pledge to be sensitive and respectful of your unique talents, abilities, and outlook on life. I pledge my support for all your dreams. Through our union, we can accomplish more than I could alone. I believe in you and the love we share together. You've been patient, helping me grow into manhood. You support my long and short-term goals. You're everything I ever wanted, and it is my solemn vow by God's grace to be everything you want and need. As we become one today, we know there will be challenges as we build. As we become one today, we know there will be challenges. As we become one today, we know there will be challenges as we build our family. But with God's help, I promise to be willing to work together and face whatever comes. On this day before God, and all these things, and all these people present, I officially give you my heart. I hope that the best parts of me always fits perfectly with the best parts of you. I promise to love you in good times and in bad, with all that I have to give. And the only way God loves me completely, forever, and unconditionally. I cherish the opportunity to be on this journey with you, falling in love a little more every day. I promise to love and cherish you through whatever life may bring us, till death do us part. With God's help, we will walk hand in hand wherever our journey leads us, growing, learning, and loving together forever.
Now I think I should have went first because I don't know if I could top that. You know, I like a joke. And, you know, I get it from my dad. Always laughing, always joking. But for those who don't know, this man was my first boyfriend. Ever. We met in this church on the balcony up there at 10 and 11 years old. And little do we know we are speaking to our future. Well, at least trying to. He was super shy. Super shy. So shy that he sent his sister over to speak to me. But I'm happy you did that, because I was shy too. I didn't know if I had the courage to even speak to you. So I'm glad you sent Celine over. 2 years? 2.5 years later, we spent long nights on Ubu. Y'all remember Ubu? And suddenly he disappeared. He moved back to the Bahamas, so it was radio silence. But then, eventually, you came back. And guess who was the first person you saw? Your wife. But you didn't know that yet. And some things aren't supposed to happen immediately. I noticed that. I love that it happened eventually, after all these years. Eventually, we got to this altar. Eventually, we'll own our own home. Eventually, we'll start a family. Eventually, sadly, eventually, God will call us home one day. But I'm so happy to say that I have loved and been loved by you. Here's to eventually, because I'm living in it right now.
That was awesome, ain't it? We've heard them express the sentiments of their hearts to each other, and often wedding ceremonies are demonstrations of what we term today as being in love. And someone once, in an effort to define love, trying to be philosophical, describe love as the heterogeneous conglomeration of absurdity calculated to bamboozle the autonomy of the individual to become intoxicated with its abominable and irresistible powers. If you ask me, I would say to you, that's not love. In fact, that's confusion and complication. Another person tried to define love, says that love is a feeling you feel when you're about to get a feeling you've never felt before. And that sounds more like a toothache. Because that's not love. Love is not a feeling. Love is what you do in spite of how you feel. Love is not breathless. It is not excitement. It is not the promulgation of eternal passion. In fact, That's just being in love, which many fools can do. Love is what's left over after being in love is burnt away. Those that truly love are those who grow roots beneath the earth, that grows towards each other, that when all the blossoms and the fancy leaves are falling away, then all you have left is roots that form one tree and not two. Percy, Alicia, love is a principle. It's a principle demonstrated by God. It has no conditions. It forgives easily. It does not hold grudges, does not seek vengeance. Love is that glue that binds hearts together and fortifies your union against negative and opposing forces. Love is that which keeps hope alive and keeps you close to each other, especially in those times when everyone here is nowhere to be found and you feel as if you're the only two people left in the entire world. Love is what keeps your marriage going through thick and thin, in the good times and in the not so good times. The wise King Solomon says, in fact, he asks a question, a very profound question. He says, a wife of noble character, who can find one? And he hastened to answer the question by providing a description of what a wife of noble character looks like. He said, she is far more precious than rubies. The heart of her husband trusts in her, and he lacks nothing of value, because she brings him joy and do him good and not harms all the days of his life. Percy, you're standing at the altar today beside Alicia because you're convinced that you've found a wife of noble character. Scripture also concluded that if a man refused to provide for his own, and especially those of his household, he has denied the faith and is worse than an infidel or an unbeliever. And Alicia, we all believe that you're standing here today at the altar beside Percy because you're convinced that you found in him one who will do well to provide for you and his family all the days of his life. So my counsel to you today is love each other, even in those times when you don't feel like it. And trust me, if you know anything about marriage, there will be those times. And that's the time to love even more. Practice love so that it becomes a part of who you are. So that even when you are upset, you don't have to question love. I want to share a little nugget with you that I believe if you practice it, it will go a long way in your marriage. It will not solve all the problems that comes with marriage, but it will go a very long way. Percy, there will be days when Alicia will get on top of your nerves. Remember this, you are Alicia's representative to your family. They don't know her. Whatever you say about her is what they will believe about her. So if you're mad with Alicia, do not call your mom. Don't call your father. Call her mom and her father. And the reason for this is because they know her. I've tried it. In fact, my wife's mom is my best friend. Because even when I'm wrong, sometimes my wife gets a whipping from her mom. Alicia, when you're mad with Percy, don't call your mom. Don't talk to your father. Build a relationship with his parents. Talk to them. I guarantee you, your families will stay together because she will be His mom will be your defense. His father will be your defense. And I believe it will go a very long way. Marriage requires your full commitment. So give everything that you have to your marriage. And when the time comes and you feel you can't give any more, remember this. But the God of love will always refill your cup with more to give. Percy, will you have this woman to be your lawful wedded wife, to live together after God's ordinance in the holy estate of matrimony? Will you serve her, love her, comfort her, honor her, and keep her in sickness and in health, forsaking all others, keeping her only unto yourself, so long as you both shall live?
I do.
Did he hear him?
I do.
You heard him. Alicia, will you have this man to be your lawful wedded husband, to live together after God's ordinance in the holy estate of matrimony? Will you serve him, love him, comfort him, honor him, and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep him only unto yourself, so long as you both shall live?
I do.
You heard her? Awesome. At this time, I'm going to ask all those who are here to support this couple to stand. Awesome. An ancient proverb teaches that it will take a community to support this couple. You stand here representing their friends and their families. So having heard Alicia and Percy state their intentions to each other and to God in this service of marriage, before God, do you support their union? And are you committed to strengthen their lives together, to speak truth to them in love, and with them to seek a life of love for others?
Yes, we do!
You all heard that? Yeah. Thank you so much. You may be seated. Percy, I want you to look Alicia dead on in her eyes. And I want you to repeat after me as if you are serenading her. I call upon these here present today.
I call upon these present here today.
To bear witness that I, state your name.
I, Percy McKinney.
Take you, Alicia Thomas. To be my lawful wedded wife.
To have and hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better or for worse.
For better or worse.
For richer or for poorer.
For richer or poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and cherish.
Till death do us part.
Till death do us part.
According to God's holy ordinance.
According to God's holy ordinance.
Holy ordinance.
Ordinance.
And either to.
And is it taken?
Either to.
And either to.
And this is where you're going to be very serenading now. She must believe it. I pledge you all of my love.
I pledge you all of my love.
All right. Awesome. I call upon these present here today.
I call upon these present here today.
To be a witness.
To bear witness.
That I, state your name.
That I, Alicia Thomas.
Take you, Percy McKinney.
Take you, Percy McKinney.
To be my lawful wedded husband.
To be my lawful wedded husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better or for worse.
For better or for worse.
For richer or for poorer.
For richer or for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death do us part.
Till death do us part.
According to God's holy ordinance.
According to God's holy ordinance.
And hitherto.
And hitherto.
And here's it now. I pledge you all of my love.
I pledge you all of my love.
Oh, amazing, amazing. Look her in her eyes now, bro. Yes. I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a sign of my love and commitment.
As a sign of my love and commitment.
As my life's partner.
As my life's partner.
And vow always.
And vow always.
To wear it as a reminder.
To wear it as a reminder.
Of our trust and faith.
As our trust, of our trust and faith.
In each other.
In each other.
And in the beauty,
and in the beauty
of our relationship,
of our relationship,
that you can put it on. Take your time. There you go. I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a sign of my love and commitment.
As a sign of my love and commitment.
As my life's partner.
As my life's partner.
Now and always.
Now and always.
Wear it as a reminder.
Wear it as a reminder.
Of our trust and faith in each other.
Of our trust and faith in each other.
And in the beauty of our relationship.
And in the beauty of our relationship.
whom God has joined together, let no man or woman put asunder. Alicia and Percy, you have just sealed your relationship by the giving of and receiving of a ring and the exchanging of vows. And this covenant is a relationship pledged between two people who agreed that they will commit themselves to one another throughout their lives. The most beautiful example of this partnership is the marriage relationship. You have committed here today to share the rest of your lives to each other. Today, this relationship is symbolized through the pouring of these two individual containers of sand, representing you, Alicia, and all that you were, all that you are, and all that you will ever be. And the other representing you, Percy, and all that you were, all that you are, and all that you will ever be. As these two containers of sands are poured into a third container containing white sand, representing the Holy Spirit, that divine foundation upon which your marriage is built. The individual containers of sand will no longer exist, but will be joined together as one, just as these grains of sand can never be separated again or poured out individually, so will your marriage and your union be. Awesome. Give them a round of applause. If you will, please pray with me. Eternal God, creator and preserver of life, author of salvation and giver of all grace, look now with favor upon the world you have made, the world you have redeemed, and especially upon Alicia and Percy. Give them wisdom and devotion to their communion and commitment to each other, that you may strengthen them in times of need. Be a counselor in perplexities, a comfort in sorrow, and companion in joy. Grant their lives may be knitted together in your will, that their spirit in your spirit, that they may grow in love and peace with each other and with all others. Give them grace, great God, when their hearts are broken. Give them strength when they are at odds, that they may confess their faults with each other, that they may forgive easily, that they will represent you as you have given love and favor to your church. Make their life together, O God, be a sign of Christ's love, that love to this sinful world. Bless their lives with fruitfulness and fill their quivers with blessings. Give them children in the right time that they will one day rise up and call them blessed. Give each of them fulfillment in their mutual love, that they may reach out to others and care for others. Grant that all who have witnessed these vows today may find their love strengthened, that they who have committed to someone in relationship may depart renewed and energized to strengthen their union. Enrich with grace everyone who are here today. May their friends and family be towers of strength to them. And when you come, O God, I pray that there will be a place in your kingdom for them. I pray that you will curse those who curse them and bless those who bless them. And save them in your kingdom, we pray. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. For as much as Alicia and Percy have consented together in holy wedlock and have witnessed the same before God and this company, and hitherto have given and pledged their love to each other, and have declared the same by the giving of and receiving of rings and by the joining of hands, by the power vested in me as a minister of the gospel and as a marriage officer of the state of New York, I now pronounce them to be husband and wife. In the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, and in the name of the blessed Holy Spirit.
Have you found a
Percy, I would like to use this opportunity to welcome you in the universal rank of the fraternity of married men. Alicia, on behalf of my wife who is not here, and on behalf of all the wives here today, I would like to welcome you into the universal sorority of married women. Ladies and gentlemen, I want to use this opportunity to welcome America's newest couple. Greatest, rather. Yes, they told me to say that, and I want to be obedient. Ladies and gentlemen, I want to welcome you to the greatest, newest couple, married couple in the entire world. Please help me welcome them. Now that you're married people, Percy, now that she's yours, it is customary that for them to believe that she's yours, that you greet her. Percy, you may now greet your bride. Okay, all righty. Okay, thank you. All right. Okay. Normally, wedding couples would be shy when it comes to that part. it seems as if the rehearsal went well last night. All righty. Let us pray. We pray, oh God, that you will now take Mr. and Mrs. Percy McKinney in your hands, that you will clothe them with compassion, kindness, patience, forgiveness for each other. Oh God, I pray that your grace will flourish in their lives, that when young people and those who come after them see their example, they will want to be like you because they have been like you. We ask now, God, that as they go to the next phase of this wedding ceremony, that you will go ahead of them and make every crooked part straight. I pray that you will guide them and give them strength from day to day. Because we know, Lord, that after the wedding ceremony comes the real part of the marriage. I pray that you will surround them with people who mean them well, and that you'll bless them, and they will call you blessed. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen.